all about revelations, you know what I'm saying?
Here we go. Another day from the depths of apocalypse. The other day, Brother Raymond L. Muhammad asked me a question, and we never got a chance to get into it. You know, it's along the lines where, you know, the Quran say that Allah would not put a burden on us beyond our scope. You know what I'm saying? You know. And then, you know, Brother Ray, you know, he asked the question, like, how do you know if it's Allah putting you through the trial versus you putting your own self through a trial? And me and my wife were having a conversation about that while we were taking study group Friday. And, you know, my wife made a good point. See, with Allah's trials, you don't see them coming. My goodness. And the book say also that he tries us with what we love. You know what I'm saying? Now, for us, you know, if you keep ignoring that light bill, if you keep ignoring that gas bill, if you keep ignoring that car note, if you continue to want to live up a life of immorality and degeneracy, and, you know what I'm saying? Hell, if you see the car coming, you step out in the street, and you get hit. A lot didn't do that to you. You understand what I'm saying? So it's simple mathematics, man. You know, 1 + 1 = 2, man. We know what we're doing or how what we're doing is going to affect us, because cause and effect is in full effect. Is that right? But see, Allah slipped one in on you, man, and you don't know, because he's going to try us before we love. Let's take Abraham. We were talking about this in class. We were saying, like, Abraham was Abram. Listen to what I'm saying. No, don't do that. So Abraham, he wanted a son, right? His wife was barren, you know what I'm saying? So he was given permission to go into Hagar, his wife's handmaiden, and Allah gave him a son. Man, he loved his son, he cherished his son, he reared his son, even though, you know, circumstances got Hagar and his son put out, or what have you. You know, but long story short, man, Allah blessed him with a son, you know, and Abraham loved his son, you know what I'm saying? And so, you know, the minister said Allah wants to test us to see if our love for him is pure. And when he takes us through the test, he's going to take us again. Just continue to see how pure our love is for him. So, you know, out of nowhere, or in Allah's own time, whenever he please, you know what I'm saying? He said, Abraham, check this out. I'm paraphrasing. Allah probably didn't say, yo, Abraham, check this out. That's how I probably would have said it if I was alive. Hey, yo, Abraham, yo, check this out. You know what I'm saying? This is what I would like for you to do. I want you to take your son, you know what I mean, and sacrifice him. Ooh, huh? My goodness. So, I'm sure Abraham went through a whole lot of changes, you know what I'm saying, on the inside. You know what I'm saying? And one of the things that I'm learning in these kind of situations is that, you know, I have to know. You know, say the book, the Quran say Allah wants to know the truthful from the liars. He knows, but he wants us to know whether we're truthful, whether we're lying. Like Surah 17, verse 80, you know, make me into a truthful entering. Make me go forth a truthful going forth, and grant me from thy presence and authority to help me. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, see, Allah wanted to do something with Abraham. You know what I'm saying? He had to test him first. He wanted to make Abram Abraham. He wanted to make him a prophet. He wanted to give him, make him and his seed, you know what I'm saying? Give him a nation of consequence, you know what I'm saying? A nation of longevity, you know what I'm saying? And we are benefiting from his worship and dependency on Allah, because we're that seed, huh? That ought to inherit a nation, that ought to be set up, huh, in the kingdom. You know what I'm saying? The greatest nation ever. Huh? So, anyway. So the difference, Brother Raymond, as far as I'm concerned, is you know what you're doing that's causing you trouble. I know what I'm doing that's causing me trouble, right? Man, we ain't got no business putting that on the law, right? You know what I'm saying? That's what our own hands have wrought. Is that right? Pour it to the book. But, you know what I'm saying? Allah gonna slip up on you, man. He may try you, man, with your spouse, your children, your home. You know what I'm saying? Your famine or food, you know? Yeah. Just to bring us in a little closer. Closer still. Hey, that's our word today from the Decimal Apocalypse.